All right, so we got fescue back here. I'm gonna be taking some core samples with this. Kind of a zigzag pattern throughout the yard. I'm gonna send it to the lab and we're gonna figure out exactly what the level of nutrition in the soil is. So usually I get about 15 to 20 core samples, and you know, just kind of do like a random pattern, kind of crisscrossing throughout the yard, and that it just kind of gives me an overall perspective of what's in this soil. You'd be surprised at how many people neglect to do this. A lot of companies that put product into the soil, but they don't ever test it. It looks like there's quite a bit of organic matter within this soil. It's more of a loam. I don't really get that feeling where there's a lot of clay. So it's almost like butter in some areas. That's really good. That's more of that clay. Typically has a little bit more iron in it, and iron, when it oxidizes, it turns red. That's how I can easily identify clay. And usually the darker the soil is, like this loam, it has probably quite a bit of organic matter in there. So I would say just from probing this soil and feeling the texture and looking at the color, I can tell that it has some good amount of nutrient. All right, I'm also gonna take some core samples of the front, separate from the back. We've been having some issues with germination. Could be because the previous company added some pre-emergence a few months ago, and there still may be some residual leftover from that may still be kind of stopping these seeds from germinating. So I'm gonna go ahead and take a few core samples of soil from the front and send this to the lab and go from there. Talk a little bit about the core samples that I took of the soil, why I do that. It's not just about figuring out exactly what the nutrients are in there, but it's also about looking at the pH. That's actually one of the most important reasons why anyone would want to get soil samples, is because of finding out what the pH of the soil is. Now, the pH is basically potential hydrogen. And there's a scale from 1 to 14, 1 being very acidic and 14 being alkaline. And the pH is like a buffer. What I mean by buffer is it controls the availability of nutrients that are available to the plant, to the turf, to the grass. So if the pH of the soil is too acidic or too alkaline, even though there may be enough nitrogen, enough phosphorus, enough potassium, it won't necessarily be available to the plant. There's so many weeds out here, honestly. Typically, I would pull weeds, mature weeds. These are all kind of mature anyways, but there's so many of them, so I'll probably just spray them. But what I'm also doing out here is just kind of identifying the different weeds that are in the yard, so that way when I go back to my truck and I grab, when I'm trying to figure out what herbicide I need to use, I can use the right herbicide. And one thing I'm really seeing in here a lot of are wild violets. These wild violets have a pretty deep root system, and they are really invasive, and they'll, as you can see, they'll take over an entire yard. So that's something that you want to kind of be aggressive with. You have some crabgrass in here. This type of stuff, it blends in with the yard, and a lot of people don't even realize it because from afar they just see green grass. But this is a weed. It is not fescue at all. It is not fescue. So that's something that the herbicides will treat, and I also will pull out. I'm not gonna get all these, but I'm kind of taking a surveillance of what's out here. So this is like pretty much 90% of this yard has weeds all throughout it. I'm gonna take an aggressive approach. Now it's about 90 degrees, gonna be 90 degrees for a couple of days. So, and this is fescue. So fescue is a little sensitive because especially during the summertime, it's already stressed because this is a cool season grass. So I can't really go too hard on the herbicides, but I can put some stuff down. This is also really invasive, and it blends in, and it looks like the turf that you want, but it's not what you want. And this is Kalinga. And you can always tell by these star-shaped seed heads. I want to attack these immediately, or they will take over. See, this is the indication that it's getting a lot of water right here, and it's just sitting, and the soil is just saturated. So in any type of soil, you always have pockets of air in there, but when it becomes saturated, all the water fills up those air pockets, and there's a particular type of anaerobic bacteria that is able to thrive in soil that doesn't have a lot of oxygen. All right, so I'm gonna be putting down some post-emergent, treating the weeds. I'm basically gonna do like a blanket spray. And I'm just gonna cover as much area as I possibly can. I'm putting down a type of post-emergent herbicide that is safe to spray on grasses, cool season grasses such as fescue. Doesn't really take much. Okay, so I'm gonna be adding some fertilizer. This is just nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. And although I did do I took the soil samples, and I gotta wait for the lab results to tell me exactly what is in the soil. I'm still gonna go ahead and just put a very light fertilizer down, because I know it'll be about another week before I come back, another week or two. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put this down because we are in the summertime, and the soil's warm. And I just want to get some fertilizer down on here. Now, this is fescue. It's another reason why I'm just very lightly putting down fertilizer, because fescue is more active in the fall. So that's typically when you want to do like a really good fertilizer. So I'm just going to walk it real quick, zigzag through it, put down some fertilizer. This also helps with whenever you put herbicide on cool season grass like fescue in the summertime. Since it's already stressed out, I go ahead and I put a little fertilizer in there just to help it keep its color, because I already know it's going to be stressed out. This is very light. I really don't need much. This is 25% nitrogen. So 25, 5, 10, 25% nitrogen, 5% phosphorus, 10% potassium. And 25 is actually on the high end for nitrogen.